Hello, my name is Courtney Ambrozic, a staff scientist on the computer vision team here at SAS. In this video, I'll be walking you through an automatic image segmentation pipeline demonstration using the deep learning, image, and BioMedImage action sets available in SAS Viya. These action sets provide you with powerful tools to create automatic biomedical image analysis pipelines that solve real-life problems. To give a little context to this automatic segmentation pipeline, let's start by defining the biomedical problem we'll be solving using these tools. Multiple sclerosis is a disease of the immune system that can damage the brain and the spinal cord. Patients with MS often start to develop lesions on their spinal cord, and they also tend to lose volume in their spinal cord over time. This loss of volume can be an important biomarker of the long-term effects of MS. For this reason, it's important to be able to track the spinal cord volume of MS patients over time. That's where biomedical image analytics comes into play. By analyzing biomedical images of patients, we can assess important biomarkers that will help in the care and health monitoring of MS patients. A useful tool in biomedical image analytics is image segmentation. Segmentation is the process of partitioning an image into sets of pixels. Biomedical image segmentation can be used to extract important features of biomedical images, such as to analyze the volume of organs and important structures in the body, like malignant tumors. For this task, we can use biomedical image segmentation to find regions of the image that belong to the spinal cord so that we can monitor these regions over the long term. In this demo, I'll be showing you an example of automatic biomedical image segmentation using the deep learning, image, and BioMedImage action sets. This pipeline will read in biomedical image data, train a neural network for spinal cord image segmentation, score a test set, and quantify the results. The data for this demo come from the 2017 Lung CT Segmentation Challenge. This is a publicly available data set that contains 60 patient images in the form of DICOM files. Along with these images are corresponding DICOM RT files that contain contoured regions of four different organs: the esophagus, heart, left and right lungs, and spinal cord. Let's jump into the demo. The first step in this pipeline is to load all patient images using the Load Images action. Here I'm loading in 60 images with DICOM metadata, such as the patient name, age, sex, and series instance UID. The next step in this pipeline is to load the corresponding DICOM RT data. These data essentially contain contours that show exactly where the organs are located within the 60 patient images that we loaded in. Once we have these contour data loaded in, we have to filter out the other organ contours so that we have only the contours that show where the spinal cord is. Since the spinal cord is labeled in different colors for each image, first I'm going to find out what all the spinal cord colors are within the data. Here, I'm specifying that I want the colors of contours where the organ equals the spinal cord. The next step is to take the spinal cord DICOM RT contours that were loaded in and transform them into binary images that we can use for training and testing. These binary images will be labeled to show exactly where the spinal cord is within the biomedical image. For this task, I'll use the ROI to mask step of the Process Biomed Images action. Because all the deep learning training and scoring will be happening in two dimensions, I'll also use the export step of the Process Biomed Images action to export the three-dimensional images into 2D. To constrain the solution set, here I'm defining subsets for the image slices of the data in order. This step isn't necessary, but it will increase the accuracy of the pipeline a little more. Next, I'll split the images up into training, validation, and test images. Training images will be used to train the network, and validation images will be used to validate the network and make sure the model isn't overfitting the training data. Test images will be used to do a final evaluation of how the model performs. The deep learning model I'll be using is called the UNET model, which is a convolutional neural network shaped like a U. It's made up of a series of convolution, upconvolution, and concatenation layers. In particular, the UNET model is good at producing highly accurate segmentation results on smaller training sets. This makes it ideal for biomedical image segmentation, where it's often difficult to find large sets of labeled data. There are mainly two reasons for this: patient confidentiality and the extensive labor that it takes to manually label biomedical images. Here, I'm building the UNet model from scratch by adding the individual layers to the model. Once my model is built and the training parameters are specified, I can move on to training the model. This model trains for 50 epochs. In an epoch, the model looks at every image and creates a guess for those images. It then readjusts the model weights based on the guess, and that's how it improves the results. Since the fit error is decreasing throughout the training process, the model is getting better and better at predicting where the spinal cord lies within the images. The validation error is also decreasing consistently. This lets us know that the model isn't overfitting the training data, and that it will also be able to provide accurate predictions for images it hasn't seen before. When training is complete, it's time to evaluate how well the model actually learned. I'm going to score the model with test images that the model has never seen before. Let's now visualize the results that the model has predicted. For this task, I can use the Annotate Images action to overlay my segmentation results on the original image. And here are the results of this action. In this case, the red area is the predicted spinal cord region, and the blue area is the ground truth region. To visualize these results in 3D, we'll first import the images back into 3D. Next, we use the Build Surface action to build both the ground truth segmentation image and the predicted segmentation region. These built surfaces are plotted on top of the original 3D image, and this scene can be displayed using the Miavi software for visualization. Here, the predicted spinal cord region is shown in red, and the ground truth region is displayed in green. The evaluation metric I'll be using to see how well the network performs is the dice score. If X is the ground truth and Y is the predicted segmentation region, dice is defined as 2 times the intersection of X and Y all over X plus Y. A perfect dice score is 100%, and a completely imperfect dice score is 0%. The current state of the art dice score for spinal cord image segmentation is around 95%. The dice score for the test set of images predicted by the model is 89%. Now that we have a mask of exactly where the spinal cord is for our patients, we'll use the mask-specific step in the Process Biomed Images action to fill the binary mask with the original pixel values of the image. This is useful because we can now analyze the change in pixel intensity values for patients over time. Specifically, if we had a patient with a lesion on their spinal cord, we could monitor the lesion by looking at the change in pixel values. Once the image is masked, the image regions can be quantified and evaluated. Using the Quantify Biomed Images action, we can quantify a variety of different metrics for the spinal cord region. Here I have plotted the ground truth spinal cord volume against the predicted spinal cord volume from the network. It can be seen that the network prediction mirrors the ground truth spinal cord volume pretty accurately. As I said previously, for MS patients, loss of spinal cord volume can be an indicator of long-term disability. Using an automatic segmentation pipeline like this can help monitor the health of MS patients for the long term. In conclusion, building pipelines for biomedical image analysis can help solve real-world problems. Using tools from the Image, BioMedImage, and Deep Learning action sets, you can build powerful analysis pipelines that can help with these problems. This demo outlined a specific case of automatic image segmentation of the spinal cord using these tools, reducing the burden and fatigue of medical professionals who must perform these steps manually. Quantifying the results of this pipeline has led to insights into the health of patients and the monitoring of important biomarkers. Thanks for watching.